this segment is Stash Stories, and we're going to kind of do two things in this segment. Talk about some recent and perhaps even long-standing stash, and also what we've got planned for our projects for 2017. I'm going to talk about a very recent stash acquisition first.
Ooh.
It comes in this delightful bag. It's a bit rattly here. Look at that.
Oh, that is perfect.
It is. This was a gift. This was a gift actually from my future mother-in-law. She went to Canada with her sister and husband. So
that would have been an awesome trip.
Yeah. And so very kindly brought me back some yarn, and she was very apologetic that she couldn't find Canadian yarn. But what she got me, so much better. Madeline Tosh.
Malabrigo.
No, Malabrigo. That's right. Malabrigo. Look at
that
this.
That is true to colour.
Yep. It is Rios, which is the...
I love Rios.
10-ply.
Have you used it before?
I haven't used it before, but I did have some in a red in my stash. And it feels beautiful. It is a pure super merino, and it's super wash. And this colorway is called Solace. And yeah,
you gotta show the other side as well.
Look,
because it's actually different on each side.
Yeah, it's kettle. I believe it's kettle dye.
Yeah.
So and I don't know too much about the dyeing process, but basically you start with the lightest color and chuck it in the pot. Literally, just chuck colors in on top of each other, and the yarn and the colors just kind of settle. Yeah. You know, and it stains where it lands, and that's pretty much it. So yes, this was my gift, and I absolutely love it, and I'm yet to find a project for it.
Cables, just anything. Rios is beautiful to knit with.
I think it'll be a little cow because it is beautiful. Yeah. It is definitely a next to skin yarn.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Beautiful. And the sock yarn.
I haven't got this sock.
Oh, it is divine. Mm. It's too good for your feet.
Nothing's too good for my feet.
It's just beautiful yarn. Mm. And the Rios.
Yes.
Have you seen my zigzag, Cal?
Yeah, I have. I love it.
That's Rios.
We'll pop in a picture.
Yeah. Yeah. That one I'm really quite proud of. But I didn't want to bring it today because there was no way in hell I was modelling that one. It's like 16 ply.
Oh my goodness.
It's ridiculous. Mm. But it is an awesome project. So you're going to love that. That is such a good present.
I know. So thanks, Ellie.
Yay.
Yeah.
Awesome mother-in-law.
Mm-hmm.
So something I'm going to cast on is my father-in-law, a hat I made him quite a few years ago, has died. So the request is that he wants another one. Now, I had a look through my stash, and it's kind of that moment where you go, oh, do I want to use that on someone else? Or, no, that's for me or my husband. But some yarn I've been keeping for ages, and this is nothing fancy, but it's just a great workhouse yarn, Debbie Bliss. Debbie Bliss, and I think this is the DK one, Cash Merino. So this is just a navy, and I've got three balls of the navy and one of the red. I'm only showing two at the moment, but you get the idea. And my husband was liking the idea of either going with cables for his dad or maybe do a block of blue and a red top.
Oh yeah.
Something like that. My husband said no to the pom-pom because I thought with the red block at the top and a pom-pom on, his dad would love it.
Yeah.
But
pom-poms are so in right now.
I know. I love them as well.
I really like a furry one. Yeah, I cannot make them at all.
Go old school. Cardboard.
Yeah, I tried that. The last one I made was for on top of a baby hat, and it didn't survive going through the washing machine, even though it was super wash.
I don't think I've ever washed it.
So things might look a little bit different to what they did just before the interesting technical difficulties pause, because I've misplaced the yarn I was going to talk about. So I had a bit of a dig through my stash box, or one of them.
You've just moved house as well, so...
Yes, and found another skein of yarn that I'm intending to work on this year, so...
Right up my alley, the colour.
Here it is. Slightly more green. It's kind of that perfectly teal shade. And so this is from a local Melbourne dyer. It's Little Dipper Yarns on her, is it Botes? Is that how you pronounce that? Booties?
Booties.
Booties.
I think.
Booties, sock yarn, which is a BFL. There is approximately 365 metres to 100 grams. And this is the Silver Pine colourway.
Now,
I'm going to knit one of the very, very popular socks with this, Hermione's Everyday.
I was going to say Hermione's. I want to do that as well.
Yeah, knit along.
Yes. I'm terrible at them. Remember, I'm finishing that scarf
from a year ago. Oh, so am I too.
Yeah.
Remember my cardi from 2015 for my own cardigan knit along that I still got in pieces because I haven't finished it. Yeah, so, you know, it's
not great.
We'll do it as a hoe cow rather than a faux cow. Half object,
yeah. That I can probably do.
Okay,
yeah.
So there we go.
And do you also do your socks like, that's something I take with me. So when I want something easy, I pick them up.
It depends on the pattern. Yeah. Because I'm not particularly good at socks yet. I've only completed actually two pairs.
Oh.
I've got one hoe, so hoe is a half object, so when you knit one sock, that's a hoe. Hey, ho.
She's not calling me a hoe. Well deserved, but not today.
I'm not au fait with the heel turns and things like that for on the go. I know it's easy, but
no, as in easy, we can help you. And yeah, you know,
it's just remembering how it goes. So when it's got a pattern, I've still got to have it in front of me. But
I could give you my tips for it.
Okay. Deb's tips for sock knitting on the go.
I'd have to look at my phone for my notes, but I've just got this little formula I have in my notes at all time. The cast knot, I think we're all pretty easy with, but the heel turn, it's like when you're doing the heel, I think that part, you know, I magic loop, so it's always in half.
Mm-hmm.
So I do that for... Yep. There's a certain percentage you can measure it against your toe and stuff. Your heel as well. But for me, I always get stuck at when you're doing the short rows.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got like three little words in my notes, three little lines that then trigger me for like the halfway. Yeah. So if I share that with you, I don't know it off by heart. I always go to the notes on my phone. And I'm the same with kitchening. I've got this really nifty little trick. It's a knit. Pearl, drop, whatever.
Yeah, I've got a good rhythm for kitchener.
Excellent.
Now. My first go at doing a kitchener was awful. It's so uneven, and I've pulled bits of it too tight, and it's a bit sloppy. I really should pick it out and redo it. But everyone since that first one, brilliant. And if you've done it right, it's invisible. It just works.
And I don't know where I got my little formula from now. It's probably in my notes because I like to reference where I get it. But I've also given it to another couple of friends over the years just because it says it in Knits and Purls and we're at a stage where we understand that.
I wonder if it's the same one I use. It's from the knitty.com website.
Probably. Maybe. I don't know. It's been a while.
Or knit.com, something like that. It could be the one you probably gave it to me in the first place anyway. But it explains it really well. It gives you the, you know, enter the stitch as if to knit purl. Yeah.
Knittersblog.com.
Okay. But it's very similar kind of thing. But on knitty.com, they break it down and they have pictures and diagrams as well to show you.
So
through.
This is taking it back to the bare basics. I don't know if you want to see it from my phone, but it's so good. One of my friends who was in our group, who's now moved back to the UK home, she still has the piece of paper I wrote it down on. And when she did her last pair of socks, she like Instagrammed that she's still using the formula
from what
I wrote down for her, which was really nice. But I just got it ages ago. And I think anything with knitting is you just got to find what works and makes sense to you. So share it if you want to use it.
Yeah.
Use it if you don't. But I can probably give you that link because I've got it in my notes.
Yeah. Okay, we'll put it in the show notes.
Yeah, we can give you that.
Yes. Okay.
So socks, hey?
Yeah.
Random. That's going to be good. That yarn is beautiful.
It is. It's so soft.
And she's part of our group too. I don't know if you said that.
No, I did not. So yes. Ursula is the lady behind Little Dippy Yarns, and yes, she is a regular from Richmond Knitters as well. It is a bit of a Richmond Knitters biased evening.
Yeah.
But there's nothing wrong with that. No. But yes, Ursula does tend to vend at...
Coburg,
yes. So that's the, is it Melbourne or Victorian Hand Knitters Guild show?
I think it's Victorian Knitters Guild.
And that's on in May. And then last year she also was on at Bendigo on a group store with a bunch of other vendors from around Melbourne.
Yeah. But she's got lovely dyed yarns.
They're all these solid, semi-solid colourways, and everyone, it's just so, like, the colours are really rich. I've never had any problem with bleeding with the colours.
Yeah.
And so I like it too, because Biffle is a good word, Biffle acronym. Yeah.
And I think that yarn is familiar to me because I've just remembered I've knit a pair of socks in it.
Ah.
So we can link to that as well. It's actually another of my faves. I don't have many faves because sometimes things just don't work out. But lately I've been trying to, it's like the, just that general thing in life, you know, that book came out about cleansing your stuff and just getting things that you love.
Mm.
I haven't read it, but I like that theory.
I find the whole concept of it a little too much pressure to ditch stuff.
Yeah.
It's quite a minimalist approach.
Have you read it?
I haven't read it. I've looked at some of the blogs, and I did try and download the app just a couple of weeks ago. There's another one similar, and it's called UnF Your Habitat.
What does it stand for?
It's an F with an asterisk next to it.
Okay.
So you can fill in that blank however you like.
Mm-hmm.
And it is basically for people who... actually live in the real world. So there was a description.
There's different levels.
KonMari, in my opinion, has been written for people who are stay-at-home housewives.
Okay.
Mm. Whereas UnF Your Habitat is definitely, it's much more diverse. It's broken down in ways that work for people who are neurodivergent. Or,
what does that mean?
So people with autism or ADHD and things like that, because it will break it down into really simple little steps so you can focus on one task and get that sorted.
Okay.
And also it reminds you to do the things that sometimes just escape your memory and you don't notice them until things are too late. So things like, you know, you actually need to... dust your skirting boards.
What?
I know, right?
Who? What? Yeah, no.
Actually, yeah.
You do.
Yeah.
But, I would never. Know, yeah, I don't
some,
do it
some
very
people
much.
Just don't think of. Yeah,
no,
that's
I
it.
Don't.
And they have checklists, so they break it down. Things you should do daily, like wash your dishes and make your bed, to weekly, monthly, seasonally, and it's really good. Oh. There's a book that's just come out, and. Just to clarify, we're not sponsored or anything like that by them, but
two hicks from Little Melbourne.
The book, which I haven't read yet, is basically, it says, you know, it's the step-by-step guide for people who are intimidated by KonMari.
Yeah.
And the website's really good, and I quite like
just,
it.
And so as an alternative, once again, whatever works for you, just choose that option that works for you.
Yeah.
But I like the theory... Taking what I've heard and putting it simplistic, the one thing I've kind of taken from everything I've heard or seen reviews on YouTube and stuff like that from people I watch regularly, it's just about getting the things that you love.
Yeah.
And for me, that's meant a lot because now I've got these projects that I actually love. They've worked out. I think we mentioned earlier my zigzag scarf. It's very thick and very full on for a Melbourne, but still, I just love it.
We'll have you back in winter, Dev, and we'll do a winter edition.
The sock monk, not your mother's sock monkey socks, and I don't think I ever said the name of that. I probably said it wrong. By Yarn Enabler that I showed earlier, like they're simple colours, and that's what I really love, and that kind of thing. So yeah.
Sort of though the process that I've, now I haven't read it. too detailed, but the process of figuring out if you love something is you're supposed to hold it and sit with it for a minute to see if it's still, you know.
I think Penny and I would both be doing this. Oh, shit, I called you. Sorry, I think Penn and I would both be going, no time for that.
Yeah, no, ain't got no time for that.
If that's going to take away from my couch and TV and movie time, knitting time.
Which is why I think, I don't know if your habitat is a bit more realistic.
Yeah.
Yeah. And let's face it, knitters, and particularly ones who have sizable stashes, are not minimalists.
No.
We collect. And I would think it's fair to say that, I'm not sure about the projects, but just about every skein of yarn that I own at the moment, I do love. I bought it, just about everyone tells a story, because I can, you know, tell you where I got it, when, and what reason. Most of them are, oh yeah, I got it at Bendigo, but, you know.
Yeah, well, I've shown a few from Stitches West, which, for me, when we grab them, it's that same philosophy. Sonia and I went to town. We spent up way too big. And my stash is probably a bit overwhelming at the moment. So I didn't get anything knitting related for Christmas. And probably because I treated myself way too much at the beginning of last year. Yeah. But, it's some of my earlier purchases now that is the stuff that I don't really...
Yeah. I've got a bit of that. When I've signed up to yarn clubs,
that's why I don't do it.
And I'm the same. I've decided I'm not doing.
It's beautiful, but sometimes it's not your colour, and I get too scared of them, so I just don't do them.
Yeah,
and I'm not good at cowls. As long as there's flexibility with them, I don't do it anymore because it's the pressure. The pressure gets to me. So we kind of gone. We've gone on a major tangent.
We have jumped around a bit, but that's okay.
Ursula's yarn, I think I've got the same colorway, and their socks, and they just turned out perfectly.
Mm.
And that thing again, where I really love them, and that's actually making me more happy. I don't care if I don't knit a lot of projects. It's more about I actually just want to be really happy with it.
Mm-hmm. And I've also been a similar vein. I'm only going to knit projects now that I'm enjoying working on as well.
Yeah.
It's not just about the finished object. So I think if I get, and I did it a bit last year as well, if I start on a project and I'm finding it too difficult or I'm not liking how the product's turning out, I'm not going to get hung up about how many kilometres I've knit this year, and I'm just going to frog it and find a new project. Because
I didn't even make it out of town. My kilometres would be just pathetic.
My
did five projects.
My average is around 4.5 to 5 kilometres. So in Bacchus Marsh I'd get out of town, but
no, I think I did around 2,000.
Okay.
Like I did,
but you did a lot of frogging and re-knitting, so
I did 3 pairs of socks, 1 pair of mittens. I've got that scarf that's been going for ages. But I had a pair of socks that were sucking the life out of me. They're beautiful. They're my own pattern. I haven't written it up or anything. They're just something I wanted to do as fun because I've done a few socks now.
I do have a it's probably hovering on the edge of transitioning from a whip to a UFO, unfinished object, is the socks I've been working on for the last
few months.
It's a bit of time pressure, but also because at the moment, I'm having to calculate every step of the way because it's a recipe pattern rather than a
You need a project where you don't have to think about
it. Yeah, and this is the ones I'm doing the 2 at a time toe up, and I'm just at the point where I'm doing the heel turns, and so I had to change the pattern because the pattern called for an afterthought heel, but because I'm using the gradient yarn, I wanted to put in one that was continuous so that the color change.
You want to change your colors?
No, I want the color to flow all the way through.
So what'll happen when it gets to the foot, it'll change. Yeah.
Oh, it's going to, well, because I'm doing toe up, the color changes as you go up the leg. So I didn't want to finish it and then have a completely different color going in at the heel and breaking the flow of the color. So yeah, that's why I'm doing it as you go heel rather than an afterthought.
So it's just because socks are new to you, taking that little bit extra.
Yeah, to work out the maths and, you know, like at what point it's in the pattern do you break to do the heel and that kind of thing. And,
so you have to think about it. Mm-hmm. So you need just a couple of hours to go, what do I need to do? Think, that sucks my time. Mm.
Yeah.
It's the thinking. So I've actually got a few projects. I've got another project.
Okay.
Another bag. It's showing up really quite good.
Yeah.
So this is a bag by Woolen Flower, who was Melbourne based and has now moved to Glasgow in Scotland. Makes these awesome bags.
I'm positive you might have met her when she came to Melbourne a couple of years back.
No. But her bags are beautiful, and this is one of the larger ones that I happen to nab, and it is gorgeous. Now, for our summer, I just can't carry it around. It's like a little hot water bottle it's on my legs. So I've actually got a little note here, which I'll show you. So, see if it comes up. Yeah, Woolen Flower. I think that's how you say it. And this is a tweed pouch. So she gets jackets and stuff like that, and it says here, can't read for the life of me, apparently. It's Harris Tweed.
Oh, goodness.
Sorry,
I can't read.
Jules, you're writing.
Is it Harris? Harris Tweed.
Something from upholstery.
Workshop.
Mm. So on the inside as well, there is this beautiful linen. It is thick, high quality linen. And wow. Jules, if you happen to watch this, I would like some pouches out of that. It is, you know, just putting micro requests in that for things you don't make. And I remember when you went looking for all your zippers over in the UK, and these zippers are gorgeous. I know that's ridiculous. You probably don't care about a zipper, but sometimes it's the little things. It's the quality that I really adore. So
if you'd like to send some, the postal address for the podcast is on the blog.
What, who for Jules?
Yep. Shameless
request for stuff. And this is another project I want to start. And this is a local business that popped up at Bendigo this year. And it's, did you grab something from them?
I didn't.
Anyway, I've actually got some photos of me with them, but I was being such a goose that I don't want to show anyone those photos. And Sonia's got lots of photos of me being a goose. So please don't send them in, Sonia. And then I was like embarrassing myself as if I wanted to post them. That company would be mortified. And I was doing it in front of them. Like we sat and spoke to them for ages, and they were actually, we want to go visit them.
Their mill. What's the name of
it? The name is, I held it up. It's Great Ocean Road Woolen Mills.
And if I remember correctly, they're based at what's the other one? It starts with W. I always get it confused. What? Warrnambool?
No, they're on the way. They're on the Great Ocean Road. Yeah. They're near... Do you remember the Tandi?
Yeah.
They're near... Tandi is a... They also do wool here, and it's a sheep farm. It's, from sheep to mill to yarn.
Before.
Yeah. Yes, you got some beautiful brown yarn. I've got exactly the same. And look, you could be right. Not quite sure. Great Ocean Road.
Great Ocean Road Woolen Mill?
Yeah.
Okay, they are... Yeah, Warrnambool Road in Eklund South. I think there's a Warrnambool in there somewhere.
So this yarn is... And I don't have anything about the yarn itself, but I believe it's a Merino Alpaca. Whatever yarn Tandi produce... It's theirs plus their alpaca, I think.
Okay. So it's about a 2-hour drive from here, apparently.
Yeah. So from Melbourne, it's about 2 hours as well, I thought, or an hour and a half from the city centre. But Tandi is a farm. And like Penn said, you've actually mentioned them before because I remember remember seeing your brown yarn going, oh, I've got a brown scarf around.
The fibre, yeah. The spinning.
I don't remember the fibre, but I remember you had the yarn.
Oh, that was...
an earlier project? It was a dark brown yarn. I've got exactly the same.
That's the fluff that I'm spinning.
Is it? Yep. Okay. Well, good on you. But I want to do some cabled mitts and a hat for me. I think it'd be really nice. I'm hoping grey will be okay.
Grey, it's a lovely grey.
Sometimes greys don't really work on me.
It looks something mild or that kind of, you know, that Tweety. Heather grey that we had all the t-shirts and singlets in in sort of the mid-90s.
Yeah, because sometimes it just doesn't suit my colouring. Sorry, I'm holding it above my head because of a hat. Just imagine a beautiful hat.
I think it'd be lovely.
Yeah. All right, she'll stop now. But Woolen Flower on Instagram, and she sells her her bags on her website. They come up occasionally, so you have to kind of, what do you say, track? You have to keep watch for when she's doing it.
My God, my brain has just lost.
You know what I mean? When they post, they post when they're going to do... when they're available, and you have
update,
to get
a shop update.
Oh my gosh.
We're getting hungry, I think.
Well, anyway, when she does a shop update, you need to really watch out for it and then jump on it straight away.
Falcon style.
Or tell her what colours you're after. Look, I'm not saying she'll do it for everyone, but if she's got something that comes through, it's gorgeous.
All right, I have one last thing to talk about.
Awesome.
And this was a purchase today. We discovered that here in Bacchus Marsh, we being the husband and I, that there's a bookshop here in Bacchus Marsh, and it's kind of tucked away. Its street signage isn't that clear, so we missed it the thousand times that we've driven down Main Street.
Such a shame,
and,
isn't it?
Yeah, learnt about it just before Christmas. So we went in and spent up big before Christmas, and they mentioned that unfortunately they're closing at the end of the month, but yay for us, they have 30% off everything, and so we went back and went nuts for a second time. But I didn't do a twofer, I did a threefer. Three for the price of two. I got books, three books of tea cozies, so there's no prizes for guessing what else I'll be working on this year. And
a nice small project that you can get done quickly.
Quick, yep, depending on the thickness of the yarn. But the other thing is, if you are due for a gift from me this year, unless it's for a baby, guess what you're going to get?
Spoiler alert.
Well, it's not entirely a spoiler because there's three whole books of tea cozies here, and they are completely different. Let's find one that's... Look at that, pom-pom fancy. Now, let's find another one. Oh, there's a pineapple. I have knit a pineapple tea cozy before. It was quite different to this one.
That's actually really nice.
Yeah, it was in a 4-ply and it took forever, whereas this one is in an 8-ply. And so it will knit up very, very quickly.
I'm terrible when they show the colours because I don't like the colours. I need it in black and white, I think, to actually all right, I can picture my colours in it now.
There's a cute one. Little picnic blanket. And there's picked up a few extras, a couple of gardening and house styling books.
Oh, the house
no
book
surprising.
Is, yeah. By cookbook. Shannon Luss, the house book.
The living design book. That's the cleaning. And,
the cleaning, that one.
I'll just pop over and grab it. Hang on. This is the one of the other books. It's called Completely Spotless. And it's just all those handy tips and tricks for keeping your house looking good. Because now that I am a,
Homeowner,
I want
to... So who else is it with? That's what I want to check.
Shannon Lush and Jennifer Fleming.
So Shannon Lush had a TV show on Foxtel. But her tips on cleaning using natural products are... She is amazing. She's got a lot of books out. She is
something.
So good. I need a solution for wax at the moment because over Christmas I had a candle, it burnt down to the bottom and then exploded.
Wax on fabric, what to use? Ice, plastic scraper, pins, tissue and hairdryer.
So, I don't think that would work on the crochet doily.
No. There are lots and lots of different things.
Yeah. She's good.
Is there anything else you'd like to talk about?
No, I think I've done my quota.
We might wrap up here. So, big thank you, Deb, for joining me today. This has been a whole lot of fun.
I'm so glad I invited myself.
Yes, anytime. Maybe not anytime.
Again. See you next time on Stash and Notions. Stash and Notions. Did I even get the name right?
I did.
Oh, that's amazing. All right.